So Golovkin wins by second round knockout over Vanez Motorosian. With this win, he continues his streak of title defenses at middleweight, successful title defenses up to 20, and ties Bernard Hopkins. So he made a little history in this fight. Considering all that was on the line, what had taken place before the fight, I thought that Golovkin handled this fight well. He took what most critics would say was a bad situation, Golovkin fighting Vanez, and he made quick work of Motorosian, right? Stopping him in the second round. Regardless of what you feel about Vanez, at that point of time, entering this fight, whether you thought he was a bum or not, Golovkin handled that situation just right. He stopped him in two rounds. I thought he landed a beautiful combination to end the fight. I personally give Golovkin some credit for beating Motorosian the way he did. Motorosian was never beaten by anyone like that, and he's fought a good level of competition, including some guys that they wanted Golovkin to fight, like Lara and Andrade, right? These were guys that were not even close to winning in that type of fashion that Golovkin did. So where does Golovkin go from here? Of course, there's the Canelo fight. There's the situation with the IBF and Derevyanchenko, where I think he has to August to make a fight with the number one mandatory for the IBF. I'm not exactly 100% sure, but either way, these are the choices Golovkin is going to have to face. Me personally, I would like to see Golovkin go for the unification bout versus Billy Joe Saunders. I think that's a big fight considering everything that's on the line, all the belts on the line, and so that way he can be unified champion. But of course, I understand boxing is a big business, and more than likely the big business or the big fight for Golovkin obviously is a Canelo rematch where there's a lot of money on the table. He's made a lot of money in their first fight, so of course the second fight, you can't blame him if he goes ahead and takes it, even though there may be some bullshit going on that would favor Canelo. Then of course there's the IBF, right? Will he get stripped? Will they strip him of the belt? Does Golovkin even care at this point? Is it sort of like the Marvin Hagler situation where towards the ending of Hagler's career, he got stripped of some belts chasing the Sugar Ray Leonard fight, right? Or he got stripped or he let the belt go. I'm not 100% sure. But either way, he's went into that fight not with all three belts. I noticed that there was a lot of hatred on YouTube for Golovkin, over-exaggerated hatred. You can have a dislike for a fighter, and that's fine, but to over-exaggerate, to move the goalposts, like Precise likes to say, just shows that you don't have any integrity. Shitting on the record. The record is what it is. You can come up with any excuse you want. You could come up with his reign as middleweight champion is not as good as middleweights of the past or fraudulent. Doesn't change the fact that when you look at the middleweight and you look at middleweight history, Golovkin is always going to be a part of that. So I'll be looking forward to whatever decision he makes. With that performance, it shows me that he still has that killer instinct, which in my opinion makes him an enjoyable fighter to watch. Is he slipping a little bit? Is he not in his prime? I think all of that is possible, and there's evidence of it. So I won't really dispute it that much, unless people over-exaggerate. But he's still a fun fighter to watch. And like I said, be looking forward to his next fight. That's my video. Peace.